Hello, welcome. Today let us have a problem based on midpoint theorem. And today's problem is, in the given figure, ABCD is a kite in which BC is equal to CD and AB is equal to AD. That is, already we know that in a kite, two pairs of adjacent sides are equal, and that is what is given to us. E, F and CD are the midpoints of CD, BC and AB respectively. E is the midpoint of CD, F is the midpoint of BC, G is the midpoint of AB. If it is so, we have to prove that angle EFG is 90 degree. This angle is 90 degree we have to prove. And second proof is, we have to prove is, the line drawn through G, the line drawn and parallel to FE, that means the line drawn through Z parallel to FE bisects DA, that bisects DA we have to prove. So for this we have to construct something. So let me write what is given first, what to prove first, then we'll construct. What is given is, ABCD is a kite. ABCD is a kite given. That is, CD is equal to BC given and AB is equal to AD given. Okay? And also, EFG are midpoints of CD, BC, AB respectively. Okay? Respectively. And what to prove is, there are two bits. Already it is given what to prove. First bit is, you have to prove that angle EFC is 90 degree. This one is 90 degree you have to prove. And your second bit you have to prove that the line drawn through Z, the line drawn through Z parallel to EF, parallel to FE, bisects DA. That is what you have to prove. So whatever line we draw from G parallel to FE bisects AD we have to prove. So here we have to construct something. In order to prove the above two things, we have to construct something. In order to show that EFG is 90 degree, what we have to do, we have to join BD, that is the diagonal, and also we have to join AC. And for the second bit it is given the line drawn through Z. So from Z parallel to FE we have to draw a line also. Let me name this as H, EFGH. Okay? So construction, what we have to do? Join BD and also AC. Let them intersect at O. Let BD and AC intersect at O. And also what we have done, GH parallel to EF we have constructed. Draw GH parallel to GH parallel to FE. That is already given, that we have to prove afterwards. That this H bisects AD we have to prove afterwards, we'll prove. So for that we have constructed, okay? So how to prove it? We have already constructed. We have to show that EFG is 90 degree. You know that in a kite, the diagonals intersect each other at 90 degree. One diagonal bisects the other diagonal at right angles. Okay, that means AC bisects BD at 90 degree. So now you see children, in this triangle CDB, E and F are the midpoints of DC and BC. So EF is parallel to BD. EF is parallel to BD. Same way, in triangle BCA, F and G are the midpoints of BC and AB. So FG is parallel to CA or AC. Here we got EF is parallel to BD. Here we got FZ is parallel to CA. That means, and also let us name here ABCDFGH. Okay, let me name it easier. P, this one is Q. Okay, now you see EF is parallel to BD, means PF is parallel to OQ. FZ is parallel to CA, that means PO is parallel to FQ. That means in this quadrilateral POQF, PO is parallel to FQ, PF is parallel to OQ, so POQF is a parallelogram. In a parallelogram, the opposite angles are equal, you know. So, and in a kite, the diagonals intersect each other at 90 degree. So, if this is 90 degree, opposite to this is angle EFZ, or angle PFQ is 90 degree. That means angle EFZ is 90 degree. With that, we are able to prove the first bit. And after that, second bit, I will explain you. So, what is given, what to prove, what construction step I have written. Now, I will run and do the solution. Okay? That is proof step, let me do. Proof step. What I have explained, I will do for the first bit. In triangle CDB, E and F are midpoints of CD and BC. CD and BC. Therefore, EF is parallel to DB. EF is parallel to DB. Okay? Now, in triangle BCA, F and G are midpoints of BC and AB. Therefore, FZ is parallel to CA. Let me write here. EF is parallel to DB, I wrote. That implies PF is parallel to OQ because we need this. Similarly, FZ is parallel to CA. That implies FQ is parallel to PO. FC means FQ, CA, PP. Let me write 1, 2. These are not the equations, but they are parallel. Therefore, POQF is a parallelogram. Because in this POQF, both the face of opposite sides are parallel. So, it is a parallelogram. That implies angle POQ is equal to angle PFQ, that is 90 degree. Okay? Why? Because angle POQ is 90 degree. Because in a kite, the by diagonals intersect at 90 degree. So, angle PFQ 90 degree means angle EFQ is 90 degree or not? So let me clear what is given also now. First bit also we are going to prove. I am rubbing this also. That implies angle EFC is equal to 90 degree. With this we are able to prove first bit. First bit is proved. Now, let us work out for second proof. That is what? GH drawn parallel to EF bisects AD. That we have to prove. Okay. Now you see, GH is parallel to EF. We have drawn already, constructed. But EF is parallel to DB. We got already. EF is parallel to DB. Now GH is parallel to EF. We have drawn, constructed. That means GH is parallel to BD. If GH is parallel to BD, G is the midpoint of AB. By converse midpoint theorem, H is the midpoint of AD. That is what is required to us. Okay. So let me write. EF is parallel to DB and EF is parallel to EF is parallel to GH. That implies GH is parallel to BD. GH is parallel to BD. And G is the midpoint of AB. Therefore, H is the midpoint of AD, that is by converse midpoint theorem. That is what is required to us. The line drawn through Z parallel to EF bisects DA. H is the midpoint of AD, means GH bisects AD. That implies GH bisects AD. With this, second bit is proved. I hope this is clear to you. Okay? Very simple only, little complicated means lengthy, but not at all difficult. I hope this is clear to you. Okay, thank you.